Hello everyone, happy Monday. It's Michelle Lloyd here, founder of United Art Space. And every now and again, I bring a guest in and we do an art relief session where we make art together. And it was born from the lockdown, and the aim was to bring everyone together during the time where we couldn't reach people. And we've just gone into another lockdown here in the UK. So this session today is very timely. Welcome, Romeo. Thank you for joining.
Good morning, everybody.
Romeo is one of my members. And first of all, thank you for being a member and supporting what we do, because it's because of all you guys being a member that we can run the session. So first of all, thank you. And thank you for volunteering to do this session today. Romeo is going to come in and show you all the art of Zentangle. And I am really curious to know what this is as well. And it's going to be a kind of art therapy, releasing stress. And we will follow along as Romeo demonstrates this Zentangle art. And he has loads of tutorials on YouTube and has just started to get this off the ground, haven't you? So sharing your links, and we've just figured out a nifty way to show them. Yeah. So we've seen his website appearing in a minute. So Romeo, before we delve in, tell us a little bit about yourself and the art that you make, and how you got into this Zentangle art.
I will do. Morning habits. Hope everyone is all good and everything. So yes, welcome you all. So my name is Romeo. Now I'm actually a sketch artist. I've been realistically, I draw from quite a realism. All my pictures are using graph art pencils. I draw from photographs, which are pretty much realistic drawings. I'll show you a quick example of one that I've drawn, of this one here of Mike Tyson.
Wow.
I drew that one. The good thing about this is that I've actually been drawing since January of last year. I've no experiences in drawing whatsoever. I've actually been a hairdresser for the last 25 years now. I've also been a photographer, so a lot of my work was digitally based. So a lot of it was using Photoshop, photo manipulations, things like that. I used to do a lot of that sort of stuff. And then it wasn't until last year that I decided to do something a bit different. I used to draw as a kid, cartoon characters, comic book characters, very pen and ink stuff. It was never sketches or anything like that. I decided to do a bit of drawing last year, and I first started off drawing hair, and then I couldn't draw any eyes or any details or anything like that. But within the 6 months of watching YouTube videos and things like that, I was starting to draw full portraits. But in doing that as well, it hit a time to me of where things weren't going so right for me. You know, I was suffering from a lot of mental health issues and things like that. And I found these Zentangle videos up on YouTube. I did, and they are very relaxing. They are very therapeutic videos, and they somewhat got me through a lot of hard times by drawing these, because I was in my own little world, and you're just creating something that, even if you are not a good artist, as long as you can draw an S shape, a circle, a line, a straight line, or anything like that, you can draw these pictures. You can. This is why I like to encourage people to come out of their comfort zone and be as creative. I do believe that everyone has creativeness in them. They do. They just got to find a way of unlocking it. They do. Everyone always asks people, are you creative or anything? No, I don't do. I don't. I'm not creative at all. But I do cook. Well, funny enough, that is a creativity side to it as well. So a lot of people don't understand what their creativity is in them until someone actually tells them what it is as well.
Yeah.
But these entangled pictures that I started to draw, like I say, anyone can draw them. I'm going to show you a few examples of ones that I have done. But first of all, the word Zentangle itself, if you split the word up, you have Zen, which is obviously meaning calm, relaxed, and then you have tangles. Tangles are the actual pictures that we actually draw. Here's a quick example. We draw them within a 3.5-inch square. We draw them in a square like that. And the brilliant thing about these, I've done, obviously, as Michelle was saying, there's loads on my website that I've created, all different ones that you can create. It's really unleashing all the artistic side that you have. The other good thing about these patterns is that when you do draw them, it's what's known as an unplanned abstract pieces of work. And basically, there is no up or down view of these pictures mm-hmm. when you create them. And that's what makes these really amazing pictures. And then if you want to as well, you can always add a tiny little shade of pencil in there as well, which makes the image pop out a little bit more. But also it unleashes a little bit more creativity in you, because that's what these images also do as well. I mean, not only are they the benefits of these, not only are they good for hand-eye coordination to help relieve stress, but they are also good for learning curves in your own life as well. But now, when we do draw these pictures, we only use a pen to draw them. You can use a pencil to mark out your outlines and things like that, but we use a pen only because in life, unfortunately, there is no erasers, so you can't erase anything out, which is why this is a good step too, because if you make a mistake in any of these pictures, you can incorporate that mistake into your picture and still make it look like a decent picture as well, which in life it helps you as well. By making any mistakes you may create, you will see the mistake and then eventually you will learn how to get around it and create something a lot more different with this as well. And that's the beauty of drawing with these in a pen. It was like I was saying, it helps you with your mistakes, you know, by creating an image that is what you start off is what you start off with. You can then, so I got people messaging me left, right and center on here as well, so sorry about that. So yeah, it just helps you with any sort of mistakes that you may create in life as well. I'm going to go through a few more little notes that I have done here as well before we get started on it. But what I'm trying to say as well is that when you start to create these images, now I started creating these images for my YouTube channel because I had a lot of I started doing this throughout the first lockdown, and I was putting it onto my Facebook page, and then I had actually kids from around the world were drawing these images and they were sending me their pictures of what they were drawing and things like that. So it's a great thing to do with your kids as well, you know. It's a great way to get the kids together and have a nice little session to draw with them. Another beauty thing about drawing these, now like I said, you draw these on a 3.5-inch square. Now you can buy tiny tiles that you can individually draw each pattern on. Amazing thing is once you've got a good collection of different patterns, you can then create your own mosaic framed piece of work, and you can view it and you can add all the little pictures that you've done. It doesn't matter if it's not connecting or anything like that. You just created a whole large abstract pieces of work where you've just used tiny little images of what you've drawn yourself. And the beauty of that is that you can move them around as much as you want, take ones off, add more on. And it being a creative thing, once you start to do it, you then start to think up other ideas as well. Now, from doing those Zentangle patterns, I then moved on to creating feather patterns. So what I started to do then, I then started to create a feather. And then within that feather, I started to create all the little patterns inside of that, because I wanted to do something a little bit more different. I then moved on to creating an eye. I then did an eye. I did the same thing, drew an eye, and then I drew a pattern within that eye as well. Not only that, but I then moved on to doing a pair of lips as well. I did that. And then I did hair, and then I did a jester's hat. And then from that, then I then started to do my, which I do now on my YouTube channel, is now I do mandala patterns.
Lovely.
Now these are amazing patterns to draw. You know, they're very free people to draw as well. And what I like about drawing these patterns is when you add just a slight color in there, which just makes it, don't have to go too crazy with the color, you know, just a few little colors in there and like a little shade with your pencil just helps the image to pop out that little bit more. And then you can then go that little bit more extra. And then I then created a 3D one, which it's still, now this is what I mean about mistakes and how they can incorporate into your work. Now on this picture, there is a big mistake on this picture. Whether or not you can spot it is another thing. Now where I went wrong on this picture was where here you had that pattern there and then that pattern, I went wrong and did those two the other way round. But you don't really notice it because it's incorporated into the picture. So this is what I mean about any mistakes that you may create in your work. You can still create that, you know, you can still go ahead, still create. People won't even notice it, but you've challenged yourself into creating something different. And like I was saying, you can view this in any way you wish.
I love it. My mind is blowing here, Romeo, with inspiration.
just the one more thing as well, what I'll say as well, is when you do start to create these images as well, you're going to be hit with so many patterns and ideas. So another good thing to do is what I do is I make reference pictures. So on a plain piece of paper, using a grid, I draw a grid, and then I create all the patterns that I'm going to be doing on these, so that it just gives me a little bit more of a reference for when I'm going to be drawing any of my patterns as well. And it just gives you a good idea as well, that if you get stuck on any ideas, you know, you can just quickly go through your list of patterns and you can just draw your patterns as well. The Zentangle patterns as well are great to do as well, because they unlock a sense of artistic meditation in you as well. You know, you sit there, you're calm, you're relaxed, and it's the repetitive process of drawing a pattern that you'll find a lot more relaxing. Like I say, the repetitive process being, you know, whether you're doing like a series of boxes or squares or circles or anything like that, you're going to be doing is going to be very therapeutic. It's going to be very calming, relaxing. Like Michelle was saying, on my video, on my YouTube channel, I do create art therapy videos. I do the Zentangle videos. I do the Mandela. And I also do now ASMR videos. It's, if you are aware of any of ASMR videos that you may have seen or heard of, these videos are, ASMR is short for Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response. Now, these videos are very therapeutic videos. You'll see hundreds of these on YouTube, and they are basically just sounds that people have created. Some people like the sounds of the rain falling. They like the sounds of thunder, like the sounds of crackling wood. Some people will be chewing, talking, whispering, all things like that they will be doing. What I tend to do is on my videos, I will do map tracing. So I will have a map and I will draw. There's no talking involved. There's no music involved. All you're hearing is the sounds of the tracing paper, the crinkling of the, and the sounds of the pen. I heighten the sounds of the pen moving, and people watch it and they feel relaxed. They feel calm. You don't have to do any drawings. You don't have to follow along. Just listen to the sounds, watch me drawing. And it's very relaxing. And it sends off, basically what these videos are, they send off trigger points, which are tingle sensations that you feel from your brain down your spine. You're doing this. That tingle sensation is what is a trigger point that is encouraged in these videos that you see people creating, that I also create as well on my channel too. Today's pattern that we'll be drawing is a pattern that what we'll be drawing today is known as it's one of my favorite patterns to draw. It's a mukha pattern. We're going to be drawing one. What I'm going to be doing, demonstrating to you first, is how to draw each one of these patterns, and then we're going to draw the whole. Then we're going to draw a pattern. But what I would like to encourage you to do is, you can, yes, follow along with me, but realistically, I would like to see you draw your own picture, your own creation. This is your own. This is your own time. This is your own little world. This is your own little space. It's for you to create your own images. These mukha patterns, they originally came from an artist's back in the 1900s. It's a little bit of a history lesson I'm going to bore you with now. So it came from the 1900s. It was from a guy called Alphonse Mucha. And his surname was spelled M-U-C-H-A. Over the years, it's changed and developed into Zentangle patterns, and that would be called a Mucha pattern. What he would do, he was an artist from the 1900s. He was a painter, an illustrator, and a graphic designer. He would draw and draw these posters for cigarette ads, for theatres, for back in the days. And he was a very Art Nouveau type of artist. He was. He would incorporate these patterns in with the woman's hair. You might see a side view of a woman smoking a cigarette, and the cascading hair would eventually be these type of patterns. And that's how he would incorporate it. He did a lot of theatre work. With posters. When you look at his work, it is very timeless pieces of work. And that's why I like these patterns, because when you create these patterns and when you have quite a few of them, you will see your mind will be transported back to a timeless period of like a it's a bit like a it's like one of those history things where you might have a smell and that smell will link you to some memory that you had. I found that when I was drawing these patterns, my mind was like transported back to the 1900s, because it's got that look and feel about it that automatically makes me think back of how he's, before I even saw any of his pictures, I already imagined what his pictures may have been. And funny enough, yeah, it's exactly what you may picture it to be as well. So these are the pictures that, these are the images that we're going to be drawing. I'll go through with you in a little while on the actual way of how to draw this, and then we'll draw a full picture.
Amazing.
I do tend to rabbit on a bit, so stop me anywhere if I'm going on a bit too much. I do tend to get a bit too carried away with my talking. I do.
Everyone is tuning in saying, wow, I'm so inspired. Someone was saying, we just go back and find this comment. Suzanne said, I did small Zentangle for 20 minutes every day for a year and a half. Very interesting to see how the patterns developed and how more free I became in my watercolours. Now I get inspired to do it again. Thank you.
Yeah, that's absolutely brilliant. You know, I mean, this is what it's all about. It is all about spending a little bit of time on yourself. You know, I mean, I do encourage people a lot of the time to, it's all about, for myself, it's all about motivation and positive thinking it is. And that's what I like to encourage with my art therapy and just through my art as well. I always like to encourage people to at least have read something positive every day, whether it's a quote or anything like that. Every day read something positive, and it just sets you up for the day, which is why on my Facebook page every day I will always put up a positive quote on my Facebook page. I'll do it every day, because I want to see people to, you know, I want to encourage people to have a bit more of a positive attitude and a positive life, and encourage that in with people, which is why I do these art therapy videos as well. It's because they helped me through my hard times. I would like to think that at some point someone will watch these videos and it will help them, you know, get rid of any stress, you know, or can't, you know, any sort of anxiety they may have or anything like that. In do so will help them as well by watching and creating these videos, creating these images too.
Yeah, I quite like the points that you've raised here as well about, I love that point of the life has no eraser, and the parallel between this work and actually just allowing that to happen and letting the mistakes happen. I love that, and how that can move into your own life as well. And
totally.
And then also at the same point, that those mistakes in the art, that you find a way to use them. And that's the same with mistakes in life. You find a way that they somehow amount to something later on that you think,
exactly,
wow, I made that mistake. So I love that.
No, it's exactly it. It's just like when you're drawing something, it's just like a life path that you may be heading towards. And then all of a sudden you're going to hit a curve. You're going to hit something that's gone a bit of a mistake, but then you turn that mistake around. You do, you, like I've always said, you know, you come across two negatives, and you come across two negatives, and you try and turn that into a positive. You do, you know, and it's, like I said, I've always tried to encourage that with people. I've always said to people, my cup is never half full, we're never half empty, you know, it's always full. It is, you know, I'm always, you know, because I came from a point where, you know, it was, I pretty much saw the worst in me, you know, last year. I saw the worst in me, I did, and from that, it motivated me and encouraged me to do a lot more. And that's why I tend to grasp the world now with both hands now. And anything that comes to me now, I like to show the world what I have to offer, and to be as positive through my art, and just to show that motivation off in with my work as well. And I think it's because, I mean, last year I was a full-time hairdresser. I've now taken the risk in becoming a full-time artist and still doing my hairdressing as well, because I went through time where I was watching lots of motivational videos, lots of positive stuff, and I watched loads of quotes and things like that. And one of the best quotes that I saw and read was, it was to do with taking a risk. And I've mentioned this many a times, and that is, it goes something like this. And this God said that, if you're not willing to risk, you cannot grow. And if you cannot grow, you cannot become your best. And if you cannot be your best, you cannot be happy. And if you cannot be happy, then what else is there? Now, that has stuck with me all this time, it has. And that's why I always try and do your best, you know, to come out of your comfort zones, you know, and try and push yourself just that little bit more. Like I was saying, with my art, I started off last year of doing, you know, no idea that I was going to be sitting here today doing this video. I started off last year just drawing hair and things like that, not having the thought that I was going to be doing YouTube videos or anything like that. the progression of my Zentangle videos as well. It's, you know, it's all about progression and evolving yourself in your work. It is, you know, do something a little bit different. My Zentangle video, pictures started off with just doing the normal squares, became the feather art, the eyes and things like that.
Yeah.
And it's a great way of creating these Zentangle videos is a great way of unlocking your creativity, which you will find as well.
Yeah, I also love the idea, even if this isn't the type of artwork that you make, you know, sometimes you sit down on an evening and you think, oh God, I'd love to just make something now, but I don't want to go to my studio because I've got to get all the paints out. And it's a great way of just being creative every day. Having
totally.
Something. And having that ideas bank, I love that, that, you know, when you start to create a pattern that you think, oh, I quite like that, kind of replicate it and keep it in the bank.
Exactly.
Feeling uninspired, you can draw upon that, and it's building that visual language, isn't it? So
no, that's exactly it.
Karina says, thank you, Romeo. Romeo for president.
most welcome.
So there's loads of lovely comments coming in, which I will fire as we go through. So shall we get stuck in, guys?
Yes, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to quickly switch my camera over, and then, yes, we're going to get started. We are, yes, indeed.
So as you're flipping round, Romeo, tell me when you're done. I will read out some of the comments coming in. So Preeti says, yes, if you cannot be good, you cannot be happy. If you cannot be happy, then it's not worth it. So true. Adette, I was thinking about you. I use it in most of my artwork. Adette joined the hub a few years ago now, creating lots and lots of different kinds of work, and found this kind of art. And that's what you make now on a regular basis. So I thought about you, Adette. Linda's clicked on your link to watch some of your videos. Very interesting.
Brilliant.
We're surprised to see your map tracing videos. So relaxing.
They are. I have so many people that sort of watch these videos, and they absolutely love them. They find them very relaxing. They do. And they're great little videos. They are. I do different ones now as well. I'm going to start to incorporate different videos with different sound effects, and to show people something a little bit more different in them there. But it's great. Thank you all for watching and tuning in. It's absolutely brilliant. Right. Okay, right. We are now set up. Perfect.
Lovely. Lorna says, I like being a hobbit. So Romeo. I'm going to switch now, everyone, to Romeo's screen so you can see him as he does this session. So here we go.
Brilliant. Here we go. Okay, right. So here we have the Mooka patterns that I was talking about earlier on. The first one, what you're going to be doing is this one here. Now, what you'll see with this pattern, it looks like it's a bit of an optical illusion. There's no starting points or anything like that. If you think of drawing this as if you're drawing a heart shape, the way we're going to draw this, though, I'm going to quickly demonstrate it first. The way we're going to draw this is we're going to come, you're working inside of the pattern, not outside of it, you're working within the pattern you are. So you're going to start off by coming up and round, and then you're going to come here, come round here, there, and then you're going to come in. So I'm going to give a quick demonstration of how that's going to look. So we're going to start off from this point, come up, come round to that point. We're then going to come in to here. Then we're going to come up and round, creating that curve shape again to there. Then we're going to come back in again. You see what I mean? But we're moving within inside the pattern. Come in, and then we're going to finish it off with that little pattern there. These variations, you don't have to create it like that. You can create these patterns to be a little bit more like this as well. This is what I mean about, you know, you don't have to just stick to that one pattern. You can create different patterns as well using this technique. Now we're going to go on to this one here, which is a bit more of a tangled Mooka pattern. The same scenario still. We're still going to follow this image here. We're still going to follow the same example, but we're going to come up, round, come down. But this time we're going to come in to this bit, and we're just going to overlap that stem there. We're going to come in through here, and then we're just going to come up through this point and drag that bit down to there. So that is creating that one, the 3D Mooka pattern now. This one is great for when you sort of want to create a few more variations of it, and you want to create a bit more of a tangled pattern as well. You can elongate these a little bit more, you can as well. The 3D one, now it's a little bit more involved with this one, and what we're going to be doing is we're not going to be creating it like how we did these. So we're not going to be coming in, we're going to be coming out, and we're going to become slightly a bit more out, so we have a little bit more room to create the 3D effect. So I'm going to demonstrate. Yeah.
Could you do that last one again? I've just had someone ask if you could just do that one again, that last
this one
again.
Here.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so we'll do that one again. So this one here, we're going to come, I'll do it slowly this time. We're going to come up and round, come back in again. We'll stop there. We're then going to come back up again, still coming up round, just like how we did this one, but we're going to come up and round here. But rather than stop, we're just going to go over. So you're crossing over to this stem here, bringing that in, round like that. Then we're going to come back in through here. Then we're going to come back up and round through this stem now to there. It does look a little bit complicated, this one does. But once you get the hang of it, you can. Oh, sorry, it's moving around a bit. There you go. It does look a little bit more complicated to do, but once you've got the hang of drawing these ones, you will get the hang of drawing these patterns as well. So I'm just going to quickly flip. Move that out of the way there. Okay, I'm just going to keep those there just so that you've got a bit of reference of how. So I'm just going to go to this one now, just quickly show you the 3D Mooka pattern. So I was going to pop that one here. So what we're going to do with the 3D one is the same thing. I'm just going to start it here. We've got enough room yet. The same thing, coming up and round. Oh, went a bit wrong there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to come just out slightly through there, come in through there. And then we're just going to do a small one here like that. This gives us enough room now to create any of our 3D images that we might want to do. So start off the 3D image. We're just going to put a few little arches there. And then the same thing here as well. And this pretty much gives us our basis of our 3D look to our Mooka pattern. Do the same bit here as well. And like I say, any sort of mistakes that you can make, like I said, I've made a little bit of a mistake there, I did. Just incorporate it into your pattern. And then finish it off with this little one here. And there. And we're just going to add a few little lines just to finish it off. And then what you can do as well, is like I was saying, you know, you can add that little bit more of a shade to it as well. If you want to add something a little bit more difference as well, you know, a tiny little bit of a shade, it just helps to make the picture pop out that little bit more and gives it that added 3D effect to it. And that's the 3D. Now with this picture there, what you can do with this one is if you was to carry on creating this image, I'm just going to quickly just show you something. If you was to carry on with this image now what you can do as well is, I'm going to put it back in again. What you can do as well is where we have these little bit empty, we can just add them into a bit of a spiral just to follow along the image we created. Now, if you was to carry on with this, you could create a few more of these images, and what you would end up with is something like that. By doing your 3D image, you know, and adding a few more little shades to it, we're using a pencil, you can create a nice little pattern there, which is kind of sort of, it looks very, very odd, you know, but you know it looks very sort of like something that you find in the sea or something like that. But you know, you view it in any way possible and you'll find that it's going to be, it's going to look great whichever way you you hold your picture up. What we're going to do now that we've gotten our basics of our Mooka patterns, we're now going to create our own one now. And what we're going to start off with is, when we're creating these images, is a frame that we draw first. The Zentangle patterns are normally drawn within a frame that we create. So the first thing we're going to do, we're just going to add four little dots to now fill up our space now. Now our empty page has got something going on there. What we're going to do now is just going to connect our dots together. Doesn't matter, you know, it doesn't have to be a straight line that you create. You know, it can be a curve, it can be anything. The frame itself is obviously your creativity as well. So we're going to connect our lines together now. So we're just going to do something like that. As a quick, just a little quick framework, just to put in our work there. Now what we're going to do now is we're going to do one of those Mooka patterns. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do the one that I'm going to do is let me just see which one. This is the one that I'll be drawing. You can follow along, or you can create your own one too. So I'm just going to start off with the center point here. Going to bring it in, round, through there, and then just finish it off like that. What I want to do now is I'm going to spin this around and do the same thing on this side. Bringing it in and round, just so that we've got another little pattern there. What I may just do is I may just draw this a little bit, because I think I've just drawn it a little bit too small. So I'm just going to start this again, because I find it's a little bit too small for you guys at the moment. So I'm just going to start that one again. Right.
Romeo, Thomasina is asking a question. She says, I use felt tips for illustration. Would they be good for this, or can you recommend pens?
Felt tip pens are good for doing this, and you can use your pens. What I do tend to recommend people to use is, I use these pens here. These are Pigma Micron pens. They are, you can get these in a pack, and they have fine points on these pens, which is great for when you want to do, they come in different nibs. So when you want to create these images and you want to get into intricate details, the finer the nib, you'll get a nicer pattern in with these. So you can use a pencil, you can use your pens or anything like that. But overall, the fine liner pens are pretty much the decent ones to draw with if you do want to be drawing any of these. But yeah, by all means, create your pictures using your pens or anything like that. There you go, that's a little bit better now. There we go. So I'm just going to spin that one around now. Now we're going to come up here. That's what I like about drawing these Mooka patterns, especially as well, because you really do get into drawing it. You do, and the whole basis of, if you just the strokes that you're sort of creating as well. Of, you know, when you start to sit there on your own and you're creating, and you haven't got myself rabbiting in your ear, it's quite relaxing. It is to do, especially when you've got some Cockney bloke that should be on the fruit and veg stall telling you how to draw an art therapy picture. It's not very therapeutic.
It is.
But I'm hoping it's all right, though.
It is. Everyone's loving it. Yeah.
There we go. I'm just going to do this one here. And so we come up with a pattern that's kind of like that is. Now, rather than just stopping there, we can add a few more little bits and pieces to it. We can add another, we can do another Mooka pattern just on the corner here, but rather than doing all three, we can just do the two. So we'll just come up and round and there like that, just so it adds a little bit of difference to it. Spin it around, we can add another one in this corner here. And follow it through with the rest. Spinning your work around and looking at it in different ways as well is another great way to, I mean, you probably guys do it with your own work that you create yourselves as well, but I mean, I do tend to like sort of move my work around so I can see it in all different, in different angles. So we have this now created. Now let's go that one little bit more step further and we can start adding a few little details inside of the, now what you may find, you may find it a little bit hard to color in with these because these patterns, they don't have no ending point because you follow this line round and it's going to go off into nothingness. It is, so I tend to just concentrate on these bits here. And it just adds that little bit of a, just a little bit of difference to your work. When you just add a few more little finishing touches to it as well. And if you didn't start off with a frame, you can always add your frame afterwards as well. So I'm just going to add a few more little bits and pieces. Now, like I say, you don't have to always just stop at these points. This is what I mean about being the creative when you're, you know, creating any of these patterns. You know, you could be doodles or anything like that. It's always good to be that bit more creative and add other bits and pieces. The thing is that, the thing as well, though, it's always good to know when to stop as well. You can get a bit too carried away sometimes and it might start to go a little bit off putting sometimes in what you're creating. So we're just going to add a few more bits. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add a little tick there like that. Just so that we've got something a little bit more different. There, we've done that one there. And then also we can just add a few little dots. This is what I mean, it's always good, you know, add these little things to any of your bits of work, especially if you're creating a mandala picture or any sort of picture like a Zentangle picture or anything. Adding these little elements always adds that little bit more of a difference to your work as well. And then if you want to, with your pencil, you can always just add a tiny bit of a shade just on your edges there, just so that it pops out and makes your image that little bit more 3D looking. A lot of the time I use blending stamps to smudge my work, blend my work in, especially when doing portraits as well. I think a lot of people use the blender. They're a great tool to use, the blending stamps, especially if you're doing if you're a sketch artist or anything like that. They just help to blend in your work without using your fingers. Because at the end of the day, if you are doing a sketch work and you use your fingers on it, you're going to get the oils from your fingers onto the page. And when you go over that with your pencil, you're going to get your fingerprint. And that's the last thing you want because you can't get rid of those once you've got them in there. So here we have our final little image. Now, like I say, you can, you know, if you wanted to, you can add a little bit of color to these. Do as you please with them, you know, add a bit of color to them. You know, or you can just stick to the shading, or you can add other bits and pieces to it as well. And then when you are finished, you know, you can then add your border to it afterwards as well. So creating these images, you know, it helps you to be that little bit more relaxed. It is, you know, you can, you know, do it in your own time. You don't, you know, there's no rush in them or anything. And creating the image, anyone, it's like I said at the beginning of it, anyone can create them as long as you can do a straight line, a curve or anything like that. It's a great way of relaxing. Then at the end, you know, you can always just give it a little of a sign afterwards. And then it's the gratitude and appreciation of what you have just drawn as well. You know, you've drawn this amazing picture now, you know, to stand back and be proud of what you have accomplished and drawn as well. And like I was saying, there is no view of this up or down or anything like that. You can view it whichever way you feel pleased in how it's looking. And there we have that.
Amazing.
That image there, done there for you. So hopefully that was okay with you. Then wasn't too taxing or anything like that.
No, very relaxing. Wendy says, loving watching Romeo doing it, not managing to keep up, but I'm enjoying the process. Thank you so much for sharing. Thomasina says, I love the way the lines don't end or doesn't meet.
No,
that's possibility.
Exactly. That is the beauty of these images, especially as well. There is no ending to it. There's no line. It's just a continuous line that you are creating. But I mean, a lot of the time, what I tend to recommend to people is that if you are finding it difficult to do, there's no rush in it. There's no rush in the art. You're not in a race or anything like that. Just take your time, watch the video over and over again, and then eventually, because it's all about de-stressing yourself. You don't want to be stressed out trying to draw this. So it's the best bet is to don't stress out about it. The videos are not going anywhere. They're always going to be there. And just come back to it a little bit later when you're feeling a little bit more relaxed, and you're going to have your time to just take your time to draw them. And you'll find that a little bit more easier to do in that sort of way. There's no rush in them.
Yeah, I think it's a great thing to do as well as a warm-up before you get into your art making, or even just as a de-stress at the end of the day.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely is.
Nikki says, wow, these are really beautiful. It has given me a bit of structure and direction to my doodling. A whole new world awaits. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Excellent. Excellent. That's what we like to hear. Now, this is what I like to hear, the sort of encouragement of now getting people to get out their pens and paper. You don't need a lot to draw any of these to feel relaxed or, to de-stress yourself. A few little patterns that you can draw. I mean, another great example of a pattern that you can draw as well. This is another optical illusion. I was going to quickly just show you now as well, another optical illusion type of picture that you can draw. So I'm going to start off with just this square. This is a great one to do as well. So we're just going to start off with this square first. I'm just going to quickly demonstrate this one. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to start off with a line that's going to come up to here. And then we're going to do one that's going to come here. In the end, this does look quite complicated to do, but in the end, you'll see an amazing looking picture. So come up to this bit and then to here. Now, what you'll see is we're not hitting each corner. We're always going to be going off slightly. So this one's going to come now down. And now we're going to come to this point, to there. And then we're going to come to this point. And now we're going to come to this point. And I'm going to carry on with this motion all the way until I get to the end, until I get to the center. And then what you will see once this is finished is a really nice pattern that if you was to then create four more of these patterns together in different ways, they will come up, you'll come up with an even bigger picture that you started off with. Now you can see how that has changed all of a sudden, because you've got a curve running here, you have a curve running there, you do. Now, if you used to say to anyone, draw this picture, they would not be able to figure out how you drew this image. Now, if you can imagine this one again here, you see this bit, bit here would then be here like that there. So you would have an even bigger version of what you have just created. And then what you can do is you can do another one here and then another one here, and you'll have this huge picture. And then to make this pop out a little bit more, just through here, add that little bit of a shade just to give it that little bit more of a depth to it. And then you can just bring that in so it's a little bit more lighter through there. And then it's the same thing through this bit through here as well. So that was just a quick little demonstration of another Zentangle pattern that you can create as well of an optical illusion. But yeah, if you was to do another one on the side here as well, you'd have an even bigger piece as well. So these are great little images. This is another repetitive pattern that, that once you start to do, you can feel very relaxed in drawing this pattern as well. But you know,
so simple. But like you say, it looks so complex. But anyone can do this. You're right. There's creativity in all of us. And
exactly. You know, you just follow the simple procedures of it. You know, it's just straight lines that you're creating. You know, and like I say, if we was to do another one on this side, I'm just going to bring this round a little bit more. Then, I think to get this one to match up, you have to go in the opposite direction of it. Now, this is really rough. That what I'm drawing here.
Now. You know what I love as well. Sorry to interrupt you, as you're probably
concentrating. No. Go for it.
It is about that brain power of, you know, it is simple, but you've got to use that part of your brain that really has to do think about where you're putting the line.
And
that's the part of the brain that just focuses on something that isn't too stressful, stops your mental chatter, and that's why it's so relaxing.
Exactly. Now, as you know, it's that repetitive lines that you're creating. You know, as long as you sort of concentrating where you're placing the lines and where you're stopping and where you're starting, you know, you can, like I say, now obviously the image that we started off with was just that one. I've added the one next to it. I went in the opposite direction, and now I have this even bigger picture now by doing the same technique. But what I did is on this side here, I went that way.
Yeah.
But on this side, I went that way. I went the opposite direction.
Yeah. Hours of fun. You could play around.
Exactly.
Hours, couldn't you?
And then you could repeat that back over to the opposite side then, and then you can have more coming this side. You know, you don't necessarily have to stick to a square either. You can do a triangle as well. You know, you can do a triangle too. The same principles apply with the triangle as well. You're still going off your picture as well. You're not hitting the exactly same lines, but it's exactly same weight, and then you end up with an image like that as well. So you end up with something completely different, and you could have another triangle here, you could do another one here. You could go absolutely mad with it. You can. So, you know, that's another one to do as well. So there's a few little ideas there, a few little patterns for you guys to try out and to test out yourselves as well.
Yeah, amazing. Nick just sent a message in saying that her son, who is 20, he suffers with social anxiety, which is chronic. And he has a creative side, but he doesn't believe in his abilities. So she's going to encourage him to follow you, Romeo.
Oh, definitely.
Your goodness and Zen elements. Thank you for sharing today.
No problem at all. Most welcome. It's been my pleasure. Encourage the kids to do it. You know, they're very. It's like I was saying. I had kids from all last year's from the lockdown earlier on this year. I had kids doing the patterns, you know, they were sending me their pictures on Instagram and things like that. And it was great to see the kids drawing them. But what I actually enjoyed most was the picture that I saw was the family sat around the table with all these papers and like pens and pencils and things. And the kids, just the parents getting involved and the kids getting involved. And that's what I enjoyed most, was not only the fact that the kids were drawing my pictures, but also the fact that the whole family was getting involved and they were spending their time. There wasn't any mobile phones involved. There wasn't, you know, any sort of TV involved, or you know, no one was sitting in different rooms or anything like that. It was just a nice way of getting the family together and doing something that they enjoyed doing.
Yeah, you're so right. Thomasine has just asked a question. Do you ever measure or use tools, or do you keep them all freehand?
These images here, they're all freehand. They are. I mean, if you start to limit yourself to using rulers and things like that, you kind of sort of take away the essence of creating something that's going to be stress free, because you start to worry about is this line straight? Is that line straight? Is the centimeters right here or there? Anyway, you just want to be free with it. You know, like I say, my line here didn't exactly come right. You know, I just messed around with the line there. You know, it's all about just being free with your art. It is, you know, try a lot of the mandala patterns that I draw, that I do use tools in the mandala patterns, obviously, because they are quite intricate designs, especially the ones that are in a circle. With those, I do use a 360 degree protractor, and I reel off all the lines so that each segment I have, I can create a pattern within that pattern. So they're the only times that I will use rulers and things like that. But anything to do with the Zentangle patterns or anything like that, it's all very much freehand. It's all your own work, and it's what you do. It's what you create, and it's all to do with, and it's all to do with yourself.
Wonderful. So go and check out Romeo's website. You can see it scrolling across the bottom, which I just learned how to do today. So www.romeosketches.co.uk website. And he's on Instagram and Facebook and YouTube as well with more videos. So be sure to go and check him out and go and give him a follow. And
that'd be great, guys.
Questions before we go. I just want to take a moment.
Thank you very much for having me on board. Also as well, and if I always encourage people to message me if any sort of problems they have with any of their work, or if they get stuck or anything, you can message me on my Instagram or my Facebook or anything like that. And also I encourage people to send me their work as well. I always like to see people's work and well, all the stuff that they have created as well. But yeah, if you guys do get stuck on anything, hook me up on any of my social media platforms, and I'll get back to you.
Actually, that's a really good point. If anyone has made some Zentangle art today whilst watching, we would love to see it. And I know Romeo would too. So once I hang up this video, if you could add a comment below the video, we will be able to go back and see all of your creations from today. We will screenshot those and post them out on our social media as well. So you can't do it whilst we're live, though. You have to go in and add a comment afterwards. So wonderful. Everyone's just saying sending lots and lots of thanks, so go and check the comments out afterwards, Romeo. And
I will do.
Thank you once again.
No problem at all. Thank you, guys, everyone, for tuning in and everything. It's been my absolute pleasure. It has been absolutely brilliant. Absolutely enjoyed it. Really good.
Thank you, everybody, for tuning in, and we'll see you again soon. Okay, bye.
Cheers, guys. Thanks a lot. Bye.